There is a poison in your household, one that has killed millions of babies and adults throughout history, and you probably drink it every day.
The other day I posted an Instagram I took randomly after stumbling upon the site of the first milk pasteurization in the US. So why did I think this is important enough to pull over for, other than being a real weirdo? Like a lot of human civilization, the story goes back to beer and
science.
For much of history, humans didn't know why beverages became alcoholic, i.e., yeast eats sugar and poops out alcohol. In fact, they didn't really understand microbiology much at all. One of their best theories was spontaneous generation, meaning something from nothing. So rotting flesh just magically becomes maggots, and grapes just magically become wine. There was like a whole sect of alchemy devoted to creating homunculuses because they believed that sperm had little men inside of them, but that's for another time. In the mid-1800s, Napoleon III, yes, there were three, asked biologist Louis Pasteur to figure out why wine and beer went bad so fast. After a lot of experimentation, Louis discovered that good beer is full of round yeast cells, which is what makes fermentation possible. And spoiled beer is full of harmful long bacteria.
Oh no!
He found that to kill the bad invasive bacteria, but not change the flavor of the wine and beer, all he had to do was heat it up rapidly and then quickly cool it off. This seems pretty obvious today, but this was groundbreaking. Louis Pasteur called the process pasteurization. No one is saying he was that good at branding, and thankfully he wasn't a businessman because he shared the process with the rest of the world. As you know, the main reason why beer was so popular at this time was it was way safer to drink than water or milk. With the spark of industrialization and more people moving into cities, the days between when a cow was milked and when someone consumed the product increased dramatically. And without adequate refrigeration, milk is a perfect breeding ground for all kinds of nasty bacteria, like tuberculosis and scarlet fever. So, it was largely avoided by urbanites, and especially the poor. In the 1890s, after experimenting on guinea pigs, the milk industry embraces pasteurization, and by the 1910s, it becomes mandatory by law. This led to a milk boom. No matter what you hear on the internet, and yes, I know, this is on the internet, pasteurizing milk was a super important discovery. Raw, unpasteurized milk is illegal in 18 states. And even though it's just a fraction of the total milk sold, it accounts for 1/3 of all foodborne illness. Yes, raw milk is that dangerous. So, a votre sante to Louis Pasteur, and of course, beer.